usually permit few testimonies and very brief testimony. Anybody? The other mic is not here. Okay.
Praise the Lord. I want to bless the name of the Lord for the salvation of my soul and for three miracle alerts I received yesterday. Praise the Lord.
Three miracle alerts.
Praise the Lord.
We call in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. I just want to thank God. I want to bless the name of the Lord that I thank Him that I accepted early in my life. There's a particular job I did for somebody that involved a vehicle. The vehicle, I think maybe they flew it through on unrouted road, but I just thank God I now involved. Okay, let's see what you can do. This vehicle they have been using since 2013, but it was a big vehicle. So definitely anywhere this you have to seize it and you have to be able to compound it for the announcement. Let's see what you can do. I've been on this job since last year. I told God, I said, the first testimony I want to have is this job being released. And to the glory of God, they called me on Tuesday that, madam, they have released your job. I just thank God because I don't know what will happen if they did not release the job. I give God the glory in Jesus' name.
And as God has answered your prayer, we answer that prayer.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for salvation of my soul. I want to thank God for answered prayers. Even when the devil tried to attack me on the day of my interview, God showed up for me. I want to thank God that it was finally granted to me.
Glory be to God. And more of your requests have been granted unto you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. It happened on Monday after the early fever hour. I went to do a supply at Abuja. As I was driving out, I didn't use my seatbelt. So at Abuja Junction there, about 3-5 last one, he just jumped into my car. You didn't use your seatbelt. Oh yeah, come out, go and meet that man and discuss with him. The day that I came down, they just jumped into my car. And they wanted to take it away, so I had to enter with them. They said that your fine is 40,000 naira. You have to give us half of it or we'll take you to our office. I was angry with myself. How could I have done this? Why is this kind of thing happening to me? First day of the week and very early morning. Is it that I didn't pray or is it that what happened? You know? I was not even listening to what they were saying. I was just bitter in my heart that how could I have done this? I was not ready to even discuss with them, so they took me to their office in my two there. So immediately they came down. I didn't know it was their overall guy in Lagos State. He came and said, "You guys come here, young man, come here." He said, "What happened?" I said, "Well, I just came out from Abuja and I forgot to use my seatbelt." He said, "Is that what happened?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Now ask them. Did he tell you that what happened?" He said, "Oh God, we didn't know where he was coming from, but he drove towards us without the seatbelt." The man said, "It's not everybody you arrest, and it's not everybody you bring here. Give him his key." Praise the Lord. And I thanked him, and as I was leaving, something in my heart told me that you have to know this man. So I drove back and I told him, I said, "Sir, I want to know you. This is my car and this is what I do." And I said, "It was the overall Oga of last month. And is this what you do?" I said, "Yes, sir. I've been wanting to know people that do this business. I want to do it. I'll call you." Praise the Lord. And thank God, yesterday I want to see him in the office. And I was telling you that I'll be the one to come and see you, not you coming to see me again. Wow. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. And I see how God has turned negativity to positivity. And that will be your portion to you. Let's take what our hand onto all this. Children of God, that God has done something for and they have come to testify. Let's pray that this testimony will not turn to prayer requests again. The way that I listen to them, it shall be a glorious testimony which we share. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Who did all this?
Jesus! Oh my God!
Wow! God bless you. Today is Friday, and every Friday in early Thank God This Friday edition is usually the time we talk about the Holy Spirit and we pray in the Spirit. Today's topic has been captioned "The Drunk." What did I say?
The drunk.
You know when somebody is drunk? you know, as the normally screen. When you are filled with the Holy Spirit, not that you'll be moving like that, too. But, you know, there are so many characteristics or manifestations of somebody that is drunk. Sometimes the person behaves out of the ordinary. Sometimes this kind of boldness that comes upon the person. That's why some people, when they want to commit something, they will go and drink very well. When they want to face somebody, normally they will not be able to face, they will go and drink very well. Do you know that in the scripture they liken somebody that is filled with the Holy Spirit to somebody that is drunk? In the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18. The Bible said that we should not be drunk with wine as in excess, but we should be filled with, and be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be what?
Be filled
with the Spirit. They are trying to tell you that the manifestation of somebody that is drunk with wine in the realm of the Spirit is the same thing as somebody that is filled with the Holy Spirit. When I was growing up as a little boy, I watched a movie, Chinese movie, The Drunken Master. That Drunken Master, well, that was how he used to beat all his opponents. You know, they would see him as a drunk, but he would be swayed like this and give them one smack. Swayed like this and give them, that's how, because they would not know where he would be coming from. Just like Jesus Christ was talking to a particular man in John chapter 3 verse 8. John chapter 3 verse 8. You will not know how the Holy Spirit will solve that. See the testimony that we just heard now. It was as if he was in trouble, but God was trying to set him up for a greater lifting. I prophesy into your life, as you will be filled with the Holy Spirit, God will be manifesting gloriously in your life. The wind blow it where it listed. And thou hear the sound thereof, but cannot tell where it cometh and whither it went. So is everyone that is what? Full of the Spirit. What is God trying to say? When you pray in tongues, you're already setting up yourself for a miracle, but you don't know how it will happen. You don't know, as you're praying in the Spirit, you're already setting up the connection that you'll be having. That contract, you don't even know that the Holy Spirit is helping you to pray that this person that is looking for this connection, let him have something to do with this person and the thing will happen. But you are not even aware that that is what the Holy Spirit is praying to you. But it's always praying according to the will of God. When you are talking about wine, there are so many benefits of wine. Since they liken the Holy Spirit to wine, fruit wine of those days, that's many benefits. They will tell you, scientists will tell you that it helps you to digest. That means that whenever you hear the word of God is food. Sometimes some people hear so much, but it cannot benefit them because they lack understanding of what they are hearing. When you pray the Holy Ghost, it just helps you to understand. The wine that you also take, it helps you so many benefits of a true wine. And the Bible is not like me, the Holy Spirit. When you are praying the Holy Spirit, you are filled with the Holy Spirit that is likened to wine. That means there are so many benefits. Just like our father in the Lord, Pastor Adebe, was telling the pastors on Saturday when we had a meeting with him. They said that ensure that in your church you get people baptized with the Holy Spirit. Tell them that when you are praying the Holy Spirit, it appears as if nothing is happening. But in the time of trouble, the Holy Spirit will raise a standard because you have already charged yourself and you have already loaded your cloud. And that's what we are going to be doing in the few moments that we have. That we rest to our feet and just open our mouth and let the Holy Spirit fill us and start speaking in tongues in the name of Jesus. Masana, yibiri kushibiri kitiriba. Rakataya bababa. Yibiri kushibiriba. Whenever you are going for a particular appointment, you need to charge yourself the Holy Spirit so that you may not even know how you are going to say what you will say. But as you speak in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost will take over when that time comes. Malaka sa ba yebe le kosho kuruba, yebe le kosho kuruba ba 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 ba. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.